Today we are answering the most popular question ever on the DaleSnale channel. What is pink noise? I'm glad you guys have stopped by. Pink noise is a full spectrum noise that has an equal sounding response to the human ear across the whole frequency spectrum, but it has no pitch in it. It's all random points of static. Random noise generator, sometimes what we call it. The analogy of pink, white, brown, blue comes from the light spectrum. So the light spectrum goes from infrared to ultraviolet. And they said, well, if something's even all the way across the spectrum, we'll call it white. If something is focused on low energy, we'll call it red noise, or brown noise, we now more commonly call it. Pink noise has a little bit of a low boost, so we call it. The other ones that you'll see on my channel would be blue noise, which has a boost in the high frequency, or a cut in the lows, if you will. And then there's violet, which is even higher up there. I also made an ultra high frequency noise, which is beyond violet noise. These are rough approximations of how the light spectrum would act, so we could make an analogy to sound for listeners. Its closest cousin is white noise. White noise is equal energy across the whole listening spectrum of human hearing, which is 20 cycles to 20,000 cycles, or hertz we call it. Pink noise has a little bit of a low boost, but actually to the human ear, it sounds even. This has to do with listening perception of humans, where we need more energy from the environment to hear low frequencies at what we perceive to be the same intensity. People say, it sounds like a windy forest afternoon. It sounds like a river with white water. It sounds like the ocean. Blue noise might remind us more of a rainstorm. White noise might remind us more of splattering rain on asphalt or a metal roof. Masking is when you put a small amount of noise into your environment through speakers or through your headphones at a fairly low level, and it can take some of the jarring sound. A little bit of noise in the background can smooth out those things and give you a more focused concentration experience,
or help you get a better night's sleep.
Our ears are highly tuned to hearing things that may create danger in our nearby area. A monster rushing up behind us, a car driving by, a cracking branch. And we act very quickly and instinctively on these tiny sounds as they get louder and come into our area where we might get hurt by it. Sounds interact with our brain and all the different areas of it in all kinds of really interesting ways that we're still learning about through neuroscience. Now, it turns out some people's brain wiring is more susceptible to these sounds. And this may just have to do with the way their brain was wired from birth. It may have to do with trauma in their life, PTSD type events, hearing damage that's happened to them. Maybe they work in an auto shop, or they worked on race cars, or they do sound, or they work in a factory. All these things can affect your hearing perception. And we're learning now that that kind of damage, some of it is actually in the brain and in the wiring in between. We've just always had a little bit of noise in our lives. And guess what? The real environment has a little bit of noise in it all the time too. And that's maybe one of the reasons why we like a little noise. And nowadays we actually add a little bit of noise into digital recordings to make them feel more analog. Over the years, the broadcast industry found uses for noise, and they became popular test tones. I've used white noise and pink noise to calibrate speaker systems to see how the characteristics of the speakers work in the venue that they are being used in. There's a lot of other things people like that also soothe them in the same manner. In the 1960s, the first noise machine was invented, and that was a mechanical device. It was like a bowl with a fan underneath that would run, and it would create. Many of you might remember being put in the car and falling asleep when your parents are coming home from somewhere late at night. And it's that droning sound that helps us go to sleep. And then we move into the 2000s, enter the modern sound machine of YouTube. I really appreciate your comments. Can't do it without you guys on the other end enjoying it. That's what pink noise is.